During these episodes, we've showed you some basic movements and discussed some pretty basic concepts. We've also showed some more advanced challenges and discussed how you can design your own. Something I'd like to make clear in this episode is that the physical work is not enough. If you're not paying attention to your diet and to your recovery, you're only doing part of the work, and that gym work cannot possibly outweigh all of your other behavior. No amount of hard work that you do in the gym can balance out bad dietary decisions. No amount of hard work that you do can counteract the fact that you don't get enough sleep. All of these things work in conjunction with one another, and you spend more time eating than you do training. So you ought to spend a lot more time thinking about dietary behavior than how much exercise you get in the gym. And you spend a lot more time sleeping than you do eating. So you might want to pay attention to the restorative value of sleep before you start focusing on little tweaks in your diet. There's an enormous difference between myself and my dietary sort of rules that I follow and the person who's one of the top 5% of performers in the world, whether that's athletically or someone on screen trying to achieve a physical aesthetic. If it's complicated, you're probably not going to do it. I like the rules to be really simple, because if they're simple and easy to follow, then we'll actually do them. I think one of the most important dietary concepts is to eat for an objective, you know, to eat for a reason. I need to lose 10 pounds because I want to do 25 consecutive pull-ups. That's my objective. I'm going to go at that via diet as opposed to via training. 10 pounds overweight, that's where I am now. I want to lose 10 pounds, that's my objective. Lay off the unconscious eating. Schedule my meals, perhaps. Maybe I need to start counting calories so that I know that an egg has 70. I know that an avocado has 350. A medium-sized banana has 70. If I know these things and it becomes automatic in my head eventually, I gotta learn. It's like going to school. For 3 months or 6 months, I have to pay attention, but then I own it, it's automatic, and I can change my behavior. A few of the most important things when it comes to diet are rules that I can give to people that are easy to follow is the closer to nature, the better. If it wasn't a food 100 years ago, it's not food today. So if some guy invented it in a lab, don't eat it. Pretty simple. The more packaging it has, the further away from nature it is, probably. Another thing I like to tell people, especially if they're in a weight loss thing, I say no white at night. And that just means, you know, no bread, no pasta, no rice, no potatoes, things that are white. Yes, cauliflower is white and you can eat it. Egg whites are white and you can have that. Quit drinking beer. You take that out, all of a sudden you take out all these calories that are sugar-type calories, mainline straight into your bloodstream. You know, the presence of alcohol in the liver and in your system prevents a lot of good things from happening. Let's not overload with carbohydrate at night. Let's fuel our day with carbohydrate by having that in the morning instead. Because at night, that's, you know, I want to give myself a lot of protein at night so that during my hours of sleep, I give my body the resources to regenerate from the work I hopefully did during the day. 10 hours of sleep a night, over 4 liters of water a day. Do workouts in the gym that are actually recovery workouts, which might be 30 minutes of walking on a treadmill. It might be 30 minutes of being on a rowing machine or going for a swim, as opposed to the days when you work truly hard. Most people don't go hard enough on their hard days, and they go too hard on the days that are supposed to be easy. So if you start managing the intensity of those days where, you know, Monday is hard because I took Sunday off, Tuesday would be a little bit easier so I can go hard again Wednesday. That's an intelligent way to manage your work-rest cycle. In order to cause change, you're going to have to figure out what you're doing right now. So it'll be beneficial if during the next 1 or 2 weeks, you write down everything that you eat and then look at the end of the week and see where you might improve. So in these episodes, we've showed you some basic concepts and some very basic movements, and we've demonstrated some advanced challenges and talked about how you can design your own. We've also talked about the importance of diet and paying attention to recovery as well in order to complement the exercise that you're doing. So from here on out, I want you to do some of these challenges. Pay attention to your diet, pay attention to sleep, manage your stress. And if you do that and you do it consistently, then 30 days from now, 60 days from now, the physical opportunity that you have to do more and harder things is going to expand exponentially, and you'll be healthier as well.